good afternoon, everybody. This is Brittany Jennings coming to you live. We are over at the Hardis Welcome Center. They are letting us use their space today, so thank you, Hardis. But we are here live with Lisa Robbins with Hand in Hand. Good afternoon. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. So you are, first of all, your services are amazing, and we're going to get into like what, you know, who is Hand in Hand and how the business came to be. Mm-hmm. But tell everybody a little bit about yourself.
Well, my name is Lisa. I am a Florida native, Sarasota native, actually, born and raised. I've been a nurse for 16 years. I'm a registered nurse, BSN. First 10 years of nursing was at Sarasota Memorial Hospital, doing acute care and taking care of everything from A to Z. And then the past 5 years, I did nursing administration and long-term care and nursing rehab. So I've kind of seen the whole gamut of nursing and been around the block a time or two, I guess you could say.
Yeah, it sounds like it. It sounds like you've got great experience for what came to be, which is your business. Talk about how that was kind of the idea of it was born, and was it just kind of a natural thing that you kind of came into?
I do feel like it was a natural thing. Working in the nursing and rehab environment, I was watching patients discharge home that didn't really have the greatest plan in place or the greatest support system. So we would see those residents or patients coming back in. They would go home for a couple weeks and they'd go back to the hospital and they'd come back again because maybe they had not the support they needed or the ability to manage their chronic conditions. So I was watching that. I saw such a need with that. And then I had some family members that had illnesses as well. And so I kind of got involved with helping them stay home, maintain their independence, and do what they wanted because they didn't want to go to a nursing home or, you know, they wanted to age in place. And I said, you know what, this is where my passion is. I want to help people be where they want to be and do what they want to do. So,
and kind of piece together, you have that ability to kind of see the big picture and be able to realize like this person is in need of this or that or this resource.
Yes.
And so that's where your care management and your nursing kind of married and became one.
Yes.
And so with Hand in Hand, what are the services that you provide to your clients?
Our services range from the whole spectrum of everything. We do something as, you know, minor pillboxes, picking up refills, calling in for prescriptions. We do wound care. We do IV antibiotics. We help with ADLs, helping into the shower, getting dressed. We do random emergency check-ins. Maybe family lives out of state and they said, you know, my mom doesn't sound like she's doing so well. Something seems off. Can you please go over and check on her? So we do that, go in. We are all registered nurses. We're not a nursing agency. We're registered nurses that work hand in hand with our clients and their families. So we're going to go in and we're going to do an assessment. What's going on? How are you feeling? Let me listen to your lungs and go from there and figure out, do we need to contact the doctor? Does it warrant an emergency room visit, or is it something that we can manage at home and keep you here where you want to be?
Awesome. And I know with our area specifically, so you cover Sarasota County, or what are the areas that you're...
All of Sarasota County.
Awesome. Yes. So this area is really widely known for retirement, right? People move here to enjoy what's around, the beaches, yes, golfing, whatever it might be. And a lot of times their families are up north or they're out of town across the country. Mm-hmm. So you really are like the local family for these clients.
Yes.
The family members, I'm sure right now too, you're probably using like Zoom or whatever form of communication, but you're able to let them know and relay what's going on with your clients to their family members.
Exactly. You know, rather than a neighbor or a friend that's popping in, checking on them, yeah, they look okay. You have, you know, a trained nurse that knows your family member, that knows what might be different, and to recognize those changes, we advocate for our clients, patients. You know, if they have a need that might not be addressed, they don't know how to communicate it to their doctor, we're able to help with that. We're helping with the communication with the family, relay things back to them. This is what's going on. This is what the doctor said. Or, you know, maybe I'm seeing a decline. Maybe we need to start getting some more help in here or looking at a different avenue to take.
The doctor visits are so important because, as we know, even sometimes when we go to the doctor, we may forget what the doctor said or what we need to do. And then when you're reporting back to your family, you say, oh, the doctor said I was good, or I think a lot of people hear that family that don't go with them that are either local or out of state. So again, you're able to go to the doctor with them, you're taking notes, you're doing the follow-ups if there's medications to be picked up and managed. You're really helping with that entire process of keeping somebody in their home or in a community where they're at as safe as possible.
Yes, and a lot of times we're also making those appointments. So we're making the appointments, we can provide the transportation, go with, interpret, because a lot of times you see a lot of nodding and smiling, and then the person leaves and you say, what did they say? I don't know. Mm-hmm. Or they ordered a test, what for? I don't know. So we can help explain that. And then we're also gonna help if there are additional tests that need to be done, help schedule those, set up transportation, and so forth.
And I think it's important to kind of bring back up again that you're a nurse and your other business partner is a nurse.
Correct.
And so it just adds that element of safety and for peace of mind for families when you are going in and checking on their loved one. You know, obviously you're seeing the safety, the environment, are they eating, or you know, what's in their refrigerator, all those things, but you're also able to do those extra services that can keep somebody, again, safe at home.
Right, you know, you go in and kind of eyeballing, nurses are always assessing. You've known a lot of nurses, so you know they're always looking at everything, checking out the situation, the place, the environment. But look, oh, you know, you have a little cut on your arm, what happened to your arm? You know, let's keep, we'll keep an eye on that. I can provide wound care if needed. Sometimes it just needs an eyeball on it, but you don't, you know, it's knowing that, seeing it, and recognizing those little changes that can sometimes occur that an untrained eye might not recognize.
Absolutely. And so for people watching, let's go back through one more time the assessment process. So let's say somebody is watching and they want to contact you for their family member or for themselves. Mm-hmm. What's the process look like to get started with your services?
Usually we start out with a phone conversation, you know, trying to determine what needs might be, get a baseline. Because a lot of times people don't even know what that need is. They know that they're at home and they want to stay home, or maybe their mom or dad's at home, but they're struggling. And they know they need help, but they don't even know what kind of help they need. So we have usually a conversation on the phone, and then I call it a meet and greet. Let's just come over, let's get together, talk. Let me, you know, hear about what you're doing, how your life's going, your daily activities, things along those lines. And then what are the struggles that you're having? And we kind of put together a plan to meet those needs. So it might be popping in once a week, it might be popping in three times a week, it might just be having somebody on call that can come over and check things out. You know, but again, we would meet with that person first to get a baseline, you know, and because it's hard to know if there's been a change if I've never actually laid eyes on you before. So we would go meet, you know, and we like to meet periodically, even if it's just those, you know, occasional pop-ins, emergency wellness checks.
Absolutely. And then as far as the, just so people understand kind of the financial side, so do you bill hourly, or how does that work for your clients?
It's billed hourly. And depending on what the person's need is, it might only be a 20-minute visit. And I don't want to say visit, but perhaps I go in and we do some wound care and something, and 20 minutes later we're done. Well, I'm here and you're paying me for the hour, so what can I do while I'm here? There's a lot of times I find myself doing a load of laundry. Something that's going to help out. And
can I hire you? Just for that, please.
I take the trash out of doing laundry, you know, helping prep a small meal. One gentleman loves his butterscotch pudding, so there's extra time to make the butterscotch pudding. Or sometimes we just sit down and socialize, go through photo albums, you know, and give that social interaction that they might be missing. Or,
yeah, especially right now with just, you know, hate to say it, but how the world is. I think that isolation and that loneliness is huge. So even just, that's a great point, using your services just for the whole picture, but also for that social, just so somebody's coming in and having a conversation, right, a couple times a week would be great.
Yeah, it's not something that's necessarily job-based, I should say. It's not like I'm going to come in and I'm going to do your wound care and I'm going to get out. It's, you're my family. And that's what things have turned into, is it's a family environment. My partner feels the same way. We keep things close. It's an intimate relationship. So when I'm coming in, it's not like, who's here now? It's, oh, hey, I'm happy to see you. Thanks for coming. There's a lot of times I find myself, you know, I'll get a call, or I'll check in. I'm on my way. Do you need anything? I'll pick up a gallon of milk on my way. And, you know, that kind of thing, just, you know, something that what family would do. Yeah. You know, and that's essentially what it is we become family.
That's awesome. Yeah. Well, I want to say thank you for being here with us today. And again, this is Lisa Robbins with Hand in Hand Care Management and, shall I say, RN Services?
RN Services.
Perfect. Yes. And so reach out to Lisa if you don't know her. If you're a professional, definitely get to know Lisa. She's a great contact. And as well, I want to thank Hardest for letting us use their Welcome Center today. It's beautiful. So again, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
And I hope everybody enjoys the rest of their Friday and their weekend.